keyed chucks, to make them work, you have to have the key. And when you don't have the key, I've seen shops grind to a halt. And a few years ago, I figured this out. No one told me this. I'm sure maybe you know this already, so this isn't going to be any new thing to you. But I want to show you a way that you can take drill bits in and out of keyed chucks without a key. And it can save you a lot of time and frustration. Like each one of this drill press has its key, this Hilti has its key, and this Sioux drill has its key. And right now I'm missing the key for this. It's in a winter jacket, or it's in the laundry, or I've put it somewhere in a toolbox and can't find it, but it's been missing for about 2 weeks. And I use this drill fairly often. And so I want to show you how to do this. So all you do is you just get into your drill index box and you find the drill bit that fits perfectly in the hole here. And in this case, I believe this one is a 5/16 that fits in this right here. Then you take a pair of slip joint pliers, and if you're all worried about scratching up your chuck with the hardened steel of slip joint pliers, you can take part of an old glove and wrap it around here and bite through that, but I'm not really worried about it. As you can see, this drill press is certainly no prize pig. And all you do is just, it's as simple as that. And to lock it, it's just the exact opposite. It doesn't take much. It doesn't take much at all to lock it in place. And so for this Hilti now, this is actually a different drill bit. This is a 1564th that seems to work best with this. It's probably a 6mm hole since it's a European tool. There it is. So I'm going to put this drill bit in and lock it in place, and then I'll take it out. So I slip the drill bit in to hold the and that's all you have to do. Now for the Sioux drill that I'm missing the chuck for, I really do need to take this out. This is a lot tighter because it's got that cowl around it. And then to lock it back. So, if you've lost your drill chuck and you need to just get on with it and get your work done, is a simple technique that you can use. You know, everybody's got a pair of slip joint pliers and you got some drill bits. The drill bits, you know, I guess I should warn you, drill bits are hard, very, very hardened steel, and so you should be very careful using them, but I don't think you're putting enough force and tension just binding that end in there that you're really worrying about shattering it. But I probably should have safety glasses on right now, but I'm not worried about this shattering. I mean, it has no mechanical force going to it. It has no rotational force off of a drill bit, and so the chances of it shattering just by that light of pressure, I think, are practically zero. And I don't think it damages the drill bits, and I don't think it damages the drill. And so it's just trying to get it straight in your head which direction you go. I figured this out about 15 years ago. And I really have been in people's shops where they have lost the drill chuck, and I mean, it becomes pandemonium, you know? Nothing gets done, everybody's looking for it, you know? You got a couple drill presses that all use the same chuck, and they've only got one chuck. So they're sharing chucks between multiple drill presses, and they lose it. It's in somebody's pocket, or somebody's got it in their pocket and they've gone to lunch, or gone to run an errand. And so everything grinds down. You got to change tooling. But it's a good little technique.